The fundamental idea behind parallelization is to speed processing up by performing several tasks in parallel. However, in most non-trivial programs, different threads will need to use results of subproblems computed by each other. They can do this by storing these intermediate results in a shared or global memory space. However, an obvious problem arises here. Suppose T1 and T2 are two threads working in parallel. For the sake of argument, let us assume that T1 takes a longer time to execute than T2 does. Now, when T2 reaches a point in its execution where it needs to use a value computed by T1, it reads a designated location in shared memory. If T1 hasn't computed and written the required value into the location yet, T2 ends up with a junk value, which would not be what the programmer had intended. Clearly, we need some way to guarantee that T2 only reads the memory location after T1 has written into it. In other words, we need T1 and T2 to coordinate with each other. We need some sort of synchronization technique to fix this. In fact, the need for synchronization is one of the most fundamental problems in parallel computing. One of the simplest synchronization techniques involves using barriers. A barrier is a point in the parallel program where all threads meet before any thread moves ahead. Each thread that reaches a barrier pauses its execution and waits for all threads to reach the barrier before continuing with its execution. For example, if the instructions that T1 needs to execute are P1, P2, barrier, and P3, and the ones which T2 needs to execute are Q1, barrier, Q2, and Q3, it is possible for statements P1 and P2 to run in parallel with Q1, but not in parallel with Q2. Similarly, P3 can never run in parallel with Q1, but can run in parallel with Q2 or Q3. Assuming Q1 finishes executing before P2 does, T2 pauses its execution at the barrier until T1 finishes executing P2 and reaches the barrier too. Only then do the threads begin to execute P3 and Q2. Every barrier can be divided into two phases. The arrival or trapping step puts the threads arriving at the barrier into a wait state. A thread cannot continue execution while in the arrival step. Once all the threads have been trapped by the barrier, we enter the departure step, and all the threads are released from the wait state and can resume their execution. There are several algorithms that can be used for implementing these two steps. The algorithms can be classified into one of the following three categories: the linear barrier, the tree barrier, and the butterfly barrier. These will be discussed in further detail in upcoming videos. Here are some situations where the concept of barriers would arise naturally in the real world. During the construction of a multi-storied house, the construction of each pillar can be considered to be a thread. We would have to wait until all the pillars of the first floor are laid before we start laying out the pillars of the second floor. In a classroom, the teacher has to wait until all the students have noted down what's on the board before she can clear the board and start a new topic. Barriers can also be used in some unconventional ways. Timing a portion of multi-threaded process. We know that no thread can proceed beyond a barrier until all the threads have reached it. So, we can use barriers as a start point since all threads, including the one running the timer, start running from the barrier at the exact same time. Debugging. Debugging parallel computation becomes very difficult unless we have an idea of how far each of our threads have reached in the program. Suppose that there are two threads, T1 and T2, and that at some point of time, T1 must access a value computed by T2. If there was a bug in the code executed by T2, T1 might end up reading an incorrect value. It can be difficult to figure out the location of the bug in the parallel program. Introducing a barrier just before this value is computed by T2 can help identify and isolate this bug.